Hey friends, before we start today's episode, I have an important message to share with you. As you must be aware, due to certain new policies, you are not able to comment on our videos. But don't you worry, my friends, you can still share your valuable feedback, comments, views, and love at our email ID, peekabookidsfeedback@gmail.com. Similarly, you can also visit our Instagram and Facebook page and continue to engage with us. We are looking forward to hearing from you.
No, 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 no!
What happened?
Oh, Kitty, I saw a terrible dream. I saw that the planet is out of fossil fuels.
Fossil fuel?
Yes, little Kitty, fossil fuel. Hey, friends, looking at the present scenario, I feel that this nightmare can soon turn into reality. So, to save the world, let's learn about one of nature's best gifts to humanity that helped us to grow, develop and live an efficient life, and that is fossil fuels. Also, many of you must be having this topic in the curriculum. So, zoom in! What are fossil fuels? Decomposing plants and other organisms buried beneath layers of sediment and rock have taken millennia to become the carbon-rich deposits we now call fossil fuels. You see, a long time ago, our beautiful Earth was covered with swamps filled with various microorganisms, trees, and other large leafy plants. And as these organisms and plants died, they drowned to the base of the swamps and oceans and formed layers of spongy material called peat. Over millions of years, the peat was covered by sand, clay, and other minerals, which converted the peat into sedimentary rock. Then, over the next few years, different types of fossil fuels formed, depending on the combination of organic matter present, how long it was buried, and what temperature and pressure conditions existed when they were decomposing. And what are these types of fuels? Well, there are three types of fossil fuels, namely coal, mineral oil, and natural gas, that supplies about 80% of the world's energy. These non-renewable fuels can be obtained through mining and extraction inside the land or huge oceans. It is said that our whole human race is prominently dependent on these fuels to carry out the tasks for their existence, and without them, it would be difficult for us to coordinate our survival efficiently. Yes, my dear friends, that's because fossil fuels are utilized in nearly 96% of items that we use today, right from the electricity to heat and to transportation, while also supporting the processes that make a vast range of products, from steel to plastics. And it also played a considerable role in the Industrial Revolution by providing the necessary fuel needed to run the machinery. And as our dependency on these fuels kept on increasing, humans began to use them recklessly without considering that these fuels are a non-renewable source of energy, which does not develop in a day or two, but takes millions of years to form. Yes, my friends, I know it's hard to believe, but the fossil fuel we use today started creating from the Carboniferous period, which is even before the existence of dinosaurs. Yes, therefore, if we use this energy carelessly today, we are going to land into a devastating problem as the new fuel will take another million years to form again. And apart from this futuristic problem, there lies a bigger threat in the present as well. Yes, my dear friends, if we continue to use and burn these fuels at this rate, they also have the potential to harm the environment as they are made up of harmful chemical bonds that could be dangerous for us. You see, the coal we use is made of carbon, and when mixed with oxygen, it leads to an increase in carbon dioxide in the environment. This eventually contributes to greenhouse effects, which then contributes to climate change and cause global warming. Also, many times the oil spills into the sea during transportation, resulting in polluting it and establishing a threat to all aquatic animals and the quality of water. Not only that, but the natural gases are highly flammable that can prove hazardous if not used wisely. So, the critical question is, what do we need to do to control the damage caused by the overusing of fossil fuels? Well, we can start by using less amount of electricity or using it only when required. The lesser the consumption, the lesser the pressure on the coming generation. Next, we can install solar panels which can replace or minimize the use of natural gas. Also, it is essential to turn off your vehicle while standing on the signal. And lastly, if possible, try to switch to electronic vehicles that are environment friendly. So, here we go, friends. Just by following these small steps, we can make a huge difference to protect the environment and the coming generation.
Trivia time!
Did you know it takes almost 26 tons of raw petroleum to produce 1 liter of gas and 800 pounds of coal to power a light bulb 24/7 for an entire year? Also, the natural process of decomposition of materials would take 422 years to replace what we currently consume in a year in fossil fuels. Hope you learned something new in today's episode. Until next time, it's me, Dr. Binox, zooming out. Never mind.